Okay.
Android, I'll be teaching you user interface and user experience design using the Figma tool. To get started, you first need to download the Figma app on your desktop. To do that, we go to figma.com. Scroll to the bottom, look for resources. Under resources, click download. Figma allows you to download the desktop app for Mac OS or Windows. You can also use Figma on a Linux OS. So you have the font installer for Windows, the font installer for Mac OS. If you are downloading the desktop app, you don't need this. But if you are using the online version, which is just going to figma.com and logging in, you are going to need to download the font installer for Figma. When you want to preview your design on a live device, you have this Figma Mirror for iOS or Figma Mirror for Android. I use an Android, so I have Figma Mirror for Android. So if you are using a Windows like I am, when you click on this, automatically it downloads Figma. Then you install through the install wizard. Now what do you do next? Through the wizard, you click on sign up. If you are using a Gmail like I am, I'm using a Gmail, so I just click sign up with Gmail. It automatically loads everything, puts in my password and all that. You can decide to create a new account if you are using an alternate mail. So you can decide to put in your mail address, your password, and create account, then log in. When you log into Figma, let me click on the Figma app. It takes you to the first UI. This is the user interface. On the user interface, you have your recent, your drafts, your plugin, your deleted files, my profile, and all that. So on recent files, these are the recent projects I've been working on, or the recent projects I've opened. You see, I edited this, I did it 5 days ago in drafts. This is saved in draft, this is saved in draft, and this is saved in draft. Okay, when you click on drafts, see all your recent projects arranged by the number of days you last edited them. I did this 2 days ago, 4 days ago, 5 days ago, 6 days ago, 18 days ago, and all that. Then Figma has so many amazing plugins that allows you to do motion design, work globally, create charts, and all that. Let's click on plugin. Yeah, you see the Mapsicle. Never take a screenshot of a map again. With Mapsicle, you can easily place maps into your mockups by simply inputting the location. Image palettes, extract a color palette of 5 different colors from your selected images. Autoflow, Google Sheet Sync, Content Wheel, Upslash, Stack, Interplay. Here's my favorite plugin, Fig Motion, allows you to create motion designs inside your UI. Okay, to get started with Figma, we have to create a new file. So we're going to click on this plus icon here. Depending on network speed, that should open in 5 seconds. But the network is pretty slow today, so Figma is not responding. Give it a minute. Okay, sorry, network was a little bit poor. Okay. Figma has opened. Right here, we have all our basic tools. You have the move to our frame. This is where we create our designs in. You have the shape tool. You have the pen tool, the text tool, and the comments. Down here, you have the background. If we want to change the background here, you just click on background. Move it around. Let's see why it's changing the background. Okay. Figma is very easy to use. If you want to prototype, it's like showing your clients how the experience of the UI is going to look like. It's called prototyping. So click on prototype. When you click, what device are we using? We're using iPhone X. Preview of the mockup, background, starting frame, creating the connection, running your prototype. Then Figma has this amazing inbuilt function. Let me show you something. It gives you the ability to export your code as CSS, Android, or iOS. So let's say we want to export. Let's create a frame first. Before doing anything, you have to create a frame. Press the F key. I'm going to draw a frame. This will be my frame. I'll press the arrow key to draw a rectangle. Let me feed this. Let's go to design. Feed this rectangle with black. Come to test. Let's write Druids Academy. Okay. Since it's black, it's going to fit in with this rectangle. So let's change the color to white to bring it out. Druids Academy. Draw it to center. Let's increase the length to, let's say, about 60. Okay, it should just fit in at the center. See these lines that guides activated them. I'll teach you how to do that. These are okay. So we have Druids Academy. So let's say we want to export this as a code to our developer. Just come here, click on code. See, Figma has generated the code. The CSS for the rectangle for the Druids Academy, font family, roboto, font style, normal, and all that. Figma does so many amazing things. When you click on this drop down here, this menu drop down takes you to file. You can import from Sketch. You can place image in here. You can export frames as PDF. In edit here, you undo, redo, pick color, set default properties and all that. View, objects, vectors for vectors, text for text, then arrange, plugins, integration, Zeppelin. Enable you to hand off your designs to developers in a very neat and simple format. Then Dribbble is a website where designers post their designs and also get jobs. Then preference, what preference would you want? Library, help on accounts. Then you have these two here. These are called the bowling. So let's click on this. I want to join two shapes together or two elements together. I want to subtract, I want to intersect, I want to exclude, I want to flatten selection and all that. We use this too. This is for creating components. Sorry, this is for mask and this is for creating components. So in the next class, we'll be teaching how to work with frames, create responsive wireframes and all that. So that should be all for today. This is just a brief intro to the capabilities of Figma. Before I go, let me show you a quick design I did for Binance. Double click this. Okay, this is a user improvement design I did for the Binance trading UI. You can see here it has sell orders, buy orders, market depth, the buy button, buy order, amount you are buying, then available BTC, limit order. When you click on this drop down, if you have done the UI and prototyping, when you click on the UX and prototyping, when you click on this, it opens market order and stop limits. Then what I did here, I tried improving the user interface here, because when I'm usually trading and I want to, let's say, buy a coin at $200, not at BTC equivalent, but at the dollar equivalent, I'm always having a problem getting that. So I usually use the coin market app to do that calculation. So instead, I decided to add this. It's equivalent and it's equivalent. Let's say I'm buying just $200 worth of BNB at $34. I just impute $200 worth here and the equivalent amount of BNB shows here. So that was all I did here. So this is a very beautiful design. I'll teach you color schemes, typography, and all that. But that will be in subsequent classes. This is just a brief introduction to the capabilities of Figma. See you in the next class, and please don't forget to subscribe.